If you're a builder and you want to get better at building drastically, then the worldedit mod is for you. And today I'm going to be giving you a full in-depth guide to the mod and all of its uses that I have been using for a very long time now. So get ready, get the mod installed, hop on, and we're going to go into the first command that you're going to need to know. Also, don't forget, if you enjoy, then hit the subscribe button and check out this ratio. It's pretty disgusting. So if you could help out, that would be amazing. But let's get into the video. So the first thing you want to be able to do is get your wand, which is going to be everything that you need for this mod. So it's //wand is the first command you're going to need to know. And there we go. We have the wand in our hands, and now we can do everything that we need to. The first thing I'm going to show you how to do is select your positions. Now, what you want to do is find the corner of something you want to copy, which right here would be a corner because it is encasing everything on this side. So I would select that, and then I would go up to my other corner all the way up here, make sure it's high enough, make sure it's out this way, and it's the other corner of basically a box, and you're going to then right click this one. So you left click the first one, then you right click the second one, and then you have it. So now you have this area selected. What you want to do is come to one point where you know, which I'm going to use this block right here, and you're going to stand at it and you're going to do //copy. Okay, and that's how you're going to copy a build. Now, in order to paste this same thing that you just copied, you're going to go stand somewhere, stand exactly where you stood before. That's the way it would paste. So if I do //paste, boom, there we go. It should paste exactly how we had it over there. And as you can see, we're already learning. We got copy and paste down. Now, a tip to help you out a little bit is when you select your first spot, you don't have to place a block all the way up in this top corner. See, this is annoying if you have to build all the way to this spot. What you can actually do is fly in the air and do the command //pose2. So that'll be position 2. So you can just do that and boom, you have your second position done without even having to use the wand. Now, the next thing I want to go over is rotation. So now that we have this thing right here selected, we can copy it from this point right here with //copy and say I want this thing to be turned on its side, not facing the side that it is right now. So what I would do is from where I am right now, I can just do //rotate, and then I can rotate it either 90 degrees, 180 degrees, or 270 degrees. And you can do that -90, 180, or 270. So what I'm gonna do here is -90, and then I'm gonna stand back a little bit, like right here, and then do //paste, and that'll rotate the building -90 degrees. It always goes clockwise, so -90 would be counterclockwise. So there we go, we have it rotated. If we wanted to do 180, we could do that and then stand over there and flip it around. So just a little bit of an example of rotations. And as you can see, if I do -90 one more time and then paste it, it'll be a complete 180 from what we had originally. So you can rotate this in many ways. If I want to do it again, if I rotate it 180 degrees, it should put us back where we started, and then I paste it and it should be the same as that. So there we go, 180 degrees rotated all the way around. Guys, you can mess with this and it is really helpful when you're building. Now, the next command we're going to go over is //flip. Now, let's say you built part of a build over here on one side and you don't want to have to rebuild it again on this side. What you can do is take this selection. So I will select from right here and I will select the whole piece that I changed. So I changed this all the way down to here. So I will select all of this and I will grab that piece right there. So then I will come to the very middle of the build. You have to come to the very middle, and then you'll do //copy. And then //flip to whatever side you're trying to flip it to. So I'm flipping it to my left. So I will do //flip left, hit that, and then hit //paste to paste it there. And we should have the same thing pasted onto that side. There we go. It works flawlessly, and you can do it both ways. You can also flip things up. If you're having trouble, look, you can do //flip. And it'll give you all of the options. You can flip it directions, northeast, southwest, or up or down. There's all sorts of options, and I always use this for flipping one side of a build to the other, and hopefully that is helpful to you. Next, I want to cover /set. So I have a little box here. So what I want to do is grab this and then select this side right here. And what we can do is //set light blue concrete right here. We can do that and boom, it'll give us a box of light blue concrete. Now, let's say we're trying to build a house. So what we want to do is we want to get, you know, a little bit of a roof going here. So we will have two ends of the roof. We will have something like this, and then we can select each end just like this, and then we can do //set magenta concrete, and it'll bring us all the way across. So now this is just an example of where you could use //set, and we can do this one more time just to make it a little bit more believable. Here we go, bring that up and set it to magenta concrete. Now we will go right into the next command, which is //replace. So what we can do is we can take this build we have here. I will actually select the entirety of the build. So I will bring it all the way over here. I will select my first selection there. And then all the way on the ground on this side, I will select my other piece, which will be right here. Boom. So now we have the whole build in the selection. So what we can do now is //replace. And then you want to choose the block that you're replacing. So magenta concrete, we want to replace it with spruce wood planks. So we can do that and hit enter and boom, easy, just like that. And then we can replace the light blue concrete. So now we do replace light blue concrete with stone. And then if you want to make it multiple things, all you do is do stone, comma, stone bricks or whatever it is. And that'll give us a mixture of both. So there we go. That's how you can do set things to a block and then replace them with the blocks that you want them to be. So usually I will build out of things like this to get the shape done correctly, and then I will replace it all with the correct blocks that I want it to be. So there we go, that's set and replace. Lastly, guys, if you do something that you don't mean to do like this, if you do //cut on this and oh, you accidentally cut the wrong thing, //undo will fix whatever it is that you did and you didn't mean to, and it will replace it right away. But let's say you realize, oh, maybe it was good. You can do //redo to put it back. So guys, that'll be the end of the basic portion of the video. Those are all the super basic, simple things that you can know. And honestly, if you know those commands I just taught you and how to use them, you should be set. Most people won't need to use too much more, but I will show you some of the more advanced features of the worldedit mod. And it's not super hard to understand. It's not much more advanced than what we were just doing, but it's some more advanced tips and some interesting commands you can use. So the first one we're gonna cover is /move. Now, what I usually use /move for is when I don't like the way a build looks. Let's say I don't think this tower should be as tall as it is. I will take my wand and I will go down here. I will select the tower piece that I want to move. So I will grab all of this right here, and then what I can do is //cut, and that'll just get rid of all of that out of there. Now what I want to do is I want to take this whole selection. So let me get this corner that should include both of those up there. I will grab those and then I will come up to the very, very top. I will find the two corners again and then I will get my second position using /position2. And then now that I have this whole piece here selected, I can figure out how many blocks down I want to move it. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blocks should connect us with this right here. So I look down where I want to move it and you do /move 8 or however many it is, and boom, it should have connected perfectly. There we go. It has connected, it moved, and you can do this with many things. You can do it in any direction to say, I just want to get this out of here. I can do /move 30 blocks away, and there it is. It's all the way over there. So now that is a really, really good thing to know. And again, you can also do /undo to fix anything that you have made a mistake on. So there we go. That is the move command. And back over at our small little example over here, I will go over the stack command. Now, when you're building a house, what you usually do is, you know, you have your roof outline. Let's say I have my rough outline of my roof, something like this, and then I want to go up again, and then we'll do this, just like this. Say it was something like this, but I don't want to have to rebuild that all the way. What I can do is actually select this, come over here and get my second selection, which would be right here. And then I can just stack this as many blocks as I need. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I'll look this way. I will do /stack 11 and boom, it'll stack it all the way across 11 blocks. And just like the move command, you look in the direction you want to stack it. And there we go. Let's say I want more of these houses. Well, I can just grab this and then come over here and select my second piece over here. And then I can just stack it, well, 11 times that way. There we go. We have a whole bunch of houses going down. And this is good for big bulk builds, guys. The stack command is super, super helpful. Next, guys, this is the last thing we're going to go over. It is the brushes. So in order to use a brush, you need to pick a different tool. So just grab any tool. A diamond shovel is what I like to use. And you're going to do /br. And that's how we're going to start with brushes. You could do /brush, but br also works. Next, we need to pick the shape of our brush. So what I like to do is a sphere. That's my usual go-to. And then finally, we need to pick our material. So let's say we want to make a mountain. What you always want to use is sand or gravel or a falling block. So there we go, have sand, and then we pick the diameter of the sphere. So I'm going to go with 6, which is the biggest one you can do. But you see, if I do this now, it's just going to replace some of this and delete the ground. What I want to do is mask it. So let's do /mask air, so that the only thing that we can place the sand in is the air, which means if I place it here, it'll just fall to the ground. And when I place it here, it'll again fall. So what you want to use this brush for is building mountains. As you can see, the sand naturally kind of falls off and it'll go down and create somewhat of a mountain peak up here. Now, to fix this even more, now that you have learned the sand sphere command, you can do //BR smooth, and then you pick your size. So we're gonna just pick 2 for this, that's not too big. And then you can come down here and it'll smooth out the ground. Oh, it's even smoothing out the dirt because I masked it to the air. Let's say I only wanted to do sand, so you can do mask sand. And there we go. And now it will only touch the sand. As you can see, it'll smooth it out so you can adjust your mountains or whatever it is you're building with your brush. Another common thing I use brushes for is a tree. So if I do //BR sphere once again, but I make it out of spruce wood, spruce logs or spruce wood, and I make it the diameter of 3, and then again I mask the air, I can just create a nice little tree trunk here. So I'm gonna get some roots going, I'll get some roots coming from over here, and then we want the tree trunk here. So what I'm gonna do is fix this and make it 4 wide instead of 3 because the trunk is a little bit bigger, and then we'll build our trunk up, a nice huge tree like this, and then we'll go back to the to a 2 so that we can make the branches a little bit smaller, and then we can build our branches like this, guys. And that's a really, really cool way you can use brushes to make absolutely massive trees. And if you've seen my fantasy forest build, you will know that this is how I built the trees in that build. And then what you can do is use a brush to put leaves on it as well. Now, this final command, guys, is a one that I think most people should know. This should help so many builders. If you're a builder and you don't know this trick, you really need to be using this. This right here is going to help us make paths much easier. So what you're gonna do is make a little 3x3 in the ground and then randomize it with whatever it is material that you want in your path. There we go. That's what I think my path will be made out of. And then I will select one corner and the other, and I will copy it. Just normal copy. Then using a brush, what we're gonna do is //BR clipboard. Okay, there we go, we have the clipboard selected, which means we have this on our brush. Now what we want to do is mask grass block just like that, and now we can create paths from one thing to the other. And obviously it's square, so you're gonna have to, you know, touch it up and give it some, you know, extra attention. But here we go, we can create paths all the way around, super easy. You don't have to place any blocks and replace them or build a path one block at a time. This is a super, super simple trick to help you be able to basically paint on paths from one place to another. And as you can see, it just takes seconds and it's super, super helpful. So guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video highlighting all of my tips and tricks from the worldedit mod, and I'm sure there's some things that I left out that you maybe want to know. And if you want me to do a part 2 to this, let me know if that's something you'd be interested in, or if you have some cool tricks that you've learned through worldedit that maybe I don't know about. Let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, if you've made it all the way to the end, I definitely think you should subscribe and check out all the other videos here we have on the channel. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching the video, and I'll see you next time.